here's problem number 13 from packet number 5. So oil is leaking at a rate of, gosh, that looks really familiar. It looks like that rate that we had the other day, other problem, where T is given in hours. The general Riemann sum for the amount of oil that leaks out over the next 8 hours for the interval from 0 to 8 has been partitioned into 8 to n subintervals. And which one of these match that? Okay. So what am I looking for here? Partitioned into n subintervals, I think we can eliminate answers C and B because that expression is the real answer. But that's not what they're not asking what the real answer is. And so what is it if we partition it into n subintervals? So it's C? But that doesn't match what they asked for.
They're saying
if you change the question into partitioned into an infinite number of intervals, then C is the right answer.
Well, no, because the number of intervals, so when would be on top of the reason? Yeah.
Right. Well,
it's, wouldn't it be the same as like the integral?
I mean, this is good. This expression here, the C expression, is equivalent to the integral from 0 to 8. Oh, this is going to drive me crazy. What's that?
It might be like a changed pages gesture that you have to disable.
Or it could be that. No, I also, like, I was standing too close to the board with my book, and the book was acting like a touch point. So that was also kind of weird. Anyway, this expression is equivalent of the integral from 0 to 8 of 1,000 e to the negative 0.03 t dt. Only one e. Okay, so these two are equivalent, but again, they didn't say that. They said the Riemann sum partitioned into n subintervals. This is an infinite number of subintervals. This is really different than the kinds of problems that we have been doing. Okay. And again, I think their answer is inconsistent with the question that they asked.
So would it be D, like the way that you're thinking?
I would go with D. Although there's actually no difference between D and E. They're actually the same question. I mean, they factored out the constant 1,000.
They have a negative 0.3.
Oh, this one's got the wrong thing. Yeah, so that's the one that makes that wrong. You know, if I were to say, based on the question that they gave, I say D is the right answer. Again, B and C are wrong because they have limits. A is wrong because it's missing the 1,000. E is wrong because it's missing the negative. I would have gone with answer D. So if you got answer D, pat yourself on the back. All right. And I think what I should probably do is I should probably rewrite the problem to match the answer, in which, again, if we say an infinite number of subintervals. All right. So let's call that one done.